Welcome back to the shop. In today's video, I'm going to be working on a Japanese metalworking technique called Mokume Gane, which means wood grain metal. This process is really similar to making Damascus, but instead of using steel, we're going to use brass, nickel, and some copper. And the first step is going to be to get these as clean as possible. And to get some copper, I'm just going to cut open these pieces of tubing and flatten them out. I think that should work. I got everything as clean as I possibly can with that die grinder. Now what I need to do is cut everything to size. And this is the smallest piece of metal that I have. So I'm thinking I'm just gonna cut this into thirds and then that'll give me the size that I need to cut everything else at. I got a whole bunch of these pieces cut and deburred, and I also flattened out the copper ones quite a bit more. Considering that these were pipes not that long ago, I'm really happy with how flat they are. They hardly move around at all when I do this, so I think that's about as good as I'm gonna get them, but I think that's really good. Next, what I'm gonna do is blast them with the sandblaster a little bit just to make sure they're absolutely as clean as possible, and then I can start stacking them up. Here they are out of the sandblaster, and that should have removed any oxidation that was remaining on these pieces, but they're still a little bit greasy, so I need to clean them up with a little bit of acetone. So it makes, I only have three of these pieces of nickel, so it makes the most sense to put that in the middle. So I'll do nickel with copper on either side, and then brass against the copper, and then some more copper, a couple pieces of brass, and then do the copper again. And then I'll put the nickel up against two pieces of copper. And just keep going like that. Now what I need to do is clamp these pieces in between these pieces of mild steel. I'm gonna clamp them down as hard as I possibly can using these great big C clamps. And then I'm gonna weld these pins on there and that'll keep everything together. I'm gonna do this because I wanna avoid any air in between the layers. So you want them as tight as possible to prevent any oxidation from forming when they get really hot. Here it is all welded up, and it's been about 2 weeks since I did that actually. And in that time, I just had it in a Ziploc bag with a little bit of argon in there to make sure that it didn't oxidize. It's been 2 weeks because I just received this new fly press. Well, it's new to me, it's about 100 years old. I've been looking for one of these things for a really long time and I finally tracked one down. I'm super excited to have it and it should open up a lot of doors for me for things that I can do in this small shop. So I'll talk a lot more about this in future videos, but here it is. And yeah, I'm really excited to have it. Let's get back to this Mokume Gane. So now what I need to do is stick this in this electric kiln at about 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know exactly what the brass that I'm using is, so I think 1700 degrees is a good temperature to avoid it melting. If it melts, then I have to start over again. That would be really bad. So once it's been soaking in the heat for an hour or two, I'm gonna pull it out and quickly squeeze it in my vise. From everything I've seen online, it seems like squeezing it is actually more effective than hitting it with a hammer, so I'm gonna try that first. Mm-hmm. Well, I wasn't able to talk to you while I did this because I was wearing a respirator, but unfortunately the heat did get away from me a little bit and the brass overheated and melted and kind of squeezed out of the layers a little bit. So instead of squeezing it in the vise first, I changed it up and I just gave it some light hammer blows on the anvil, and then once it cooled down a little bit, then I squeezed it in the vise. I didn't want to squeeze it in the vise right away because I didn't want all that brass to just run out of it onto the floor. But it looks like it worked. You can see this whole stack is moving around in between the plates, so I need to take these plates off and we're going to take a look at what it looks like. Well, it definitely worked to some degree at least. I can see that there's some gaps in these layers, and that's undoubtedly from when the brass kind of squeezed out and then there was nothing in there, or there was gaps, and that led to oxidation. So it's definitely not going to be as solid as it could have been, but I'm going to grind these edges smooth and we're going to see what it looks like. Now that looks awesome. Very, very cool. I'm really happy with that. I don't know how well they're all stuck together, but they are at least stuck together a little bit. So before I start forging it anymore, I think I'm just gonna cut a slice off of here. So at least I have some of this before I potentially destroy it when I start welding it or forging it. So I'm gonna do that. And then I'm gonna stick it back in the furnace to heat it up. All right, now I'm gonna hit it against the layers. We're gonna see if this thing starts to delaminate. It seems like it's kind of solid in some areas, but it's definitely coming apart in a few spots. It's actually a lot better than I thought it would be. No, it's definitely delaminating. Yeah, that's no good. Yep, that's no good. Yeah, there we go, two pieces. Delaminated, I think that's the nickel, I'm not exactly sure. Well, unfortunately it didn't work out the way I hoped it would. It fell apart and it delaminated at the nickel and copper joint, but obviously there's all sorts of problems there. Really, there's tons of delaminations here. So who knows what happened? It's probably a combination of a lot of things, and obviously I don't really know what I'm doing. So anyways, I would call this a partial success because I did get it to stick together and this piece looks really cool. So if you have any suggestions for what I could use this for, I'd like to hear it. And if you know why this failed, then let us know in the comments. I'm sure it's just a combination of a lot of things. The biggest one being that I don't really know what I'm doing. Anyways, I had a lot of fun doing this, so hope you enjoyed watching the video, and I'll see you in the next one.